Yes. This one is the fourth question. X square plus 3x minus 4. First line, always x value. You can write x there. Second line, first term of the polynomial x square. Next to 3x. Next to minus 4. And this one is y. Y, what is y? Sum of these three terms. I took here minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Constant term also fill first. Minus 4, minus 4, minus 4, minus 4, minus 4. Minus 4. Now x square means here minus 5 whole square. 25. Okay. Now 3 into minus 5 means minus 15. Okay. Last we should add all. First we will complete these two lines. Minus 4 whole square. 16. 3 into minus 4. Minus 12. Again, x square means minus 3 whole square. 9. 3 into minus 3. Minus 9. Next one, minus 2 whole square means 4. 3 into minus 2. Minus 6. 3 to just 6. Here, minus 1 whole square means 1, 3 into minus 1, so minus 3. Here 0 square means 0, 3x means 3 into 0, this one also 0. Here again 1 square means 1, 3 into 1 is equal to 3. Next to 2 square means 4, 3x means 3 into 2, 6. Next one, 3 square means 9, 3x next term means 3 into 3, 9. Next term, 4 square means 16, next 3x means 3 into 4 is equal to 12. Now add these three. 25 minus 15, 10. 10 minus 4, 6. 3, 14. I completed here. Why? Because the video length becomes very lengthy. That's why I written all values here. 4, 24. Okay. Now let us draw the graph. This one is the graph sheet. Okay, on the y value, look at the y value, 24 is the highest value, that's why I taken 2, 2 on the y axis scale and 1, 1 on x axis. Okay, first point. Let us look at first point, minus 5, 6, minus 5 and then 6, this point. Next point. Minus 4, 0. It is located on x-axis. Minus 3, minus 4. Minus 3, minus 4. This one. Minus 2, minus 6. Minus 2, minus 6. Here, minus 2, minus 6 at this point. Now, minus 1, minus 6. Minus 1, again this value also. Minus 6. And then 0 minus 4, here 0 minus 4, x axis value 0, x value 0, that's why this point located on y axis. Now 1 comma 0, y value 0, that's why it located on x axis. 2 comma 6, 2 comma 6, this value lies on x-axis, okay? 2 comma 6 means 2, 6. Next one, 3, 14. Here 3, here 14. If you want to draw 4, then it's your choice. 4, 24. 20. So, enough, this one. And now, I will join this curve with a smooth. Okay, now like this. This one, both sides arrow mark. Okay, now this is the curve x square plus 3x minus 4. This one is our answer curve. Okay, write the Look at this one. Curve meet the x-axis at minus 4, 0 and here 1, 0. That's why we are going to write here. First here, plot the points on graph sheet and join with the smooth curve. We observe that curve meets the x-axis at 2 points. What are those 2 points? Look at here, minus 4, 0, 1, 0. Minus 4, 0 and 1, 0. Therefore, zeros of x square plus 3x minus 4 are minus 4 and 1. Justification. We can find the value of this one. Let by splitting the middle term. 3x minus 4 is equal to 0. Now 1 into minus 4. Here nothing means 1. 1 into minus 4. Already I explained this splitting the middle term in previous classes. Here 1 4s are 4 minus 4. This time we taken here minus, this one is plus. This one is our order pair. We can take this one minus 1 plus 4, then minus 3 comes here in the middle. So first of all, we can write this middle term into 1x minus 1x plus 4x minus 4 equal to 0. Here in these two x common, so x is there, minus 1. Plus in these two 4 common, again x minus 4 gone, that's why 1 is there. In these two again x minus 1 common this one, so x minus 1 and remaining x plus 4 is equal to 0. Now x minus 1 equal to 0 or x plus 4 equal to 0. X equal to, by the transformation, minus 1 becomes 1. Here x equal to plus 4 becomes minus 4. Therefore, zeros of x square plus 3x minus 4 are minus 4 and 1. Write always smaller number first and bigger number next. Okay, now next question. Yes, one. Yes, students, this one is the last question in this Roman 5th question, x square minus 1. Here middle term not given, that's why directly we can write this one. Justification first we will write. Let x square minus 1 equal to 0, then x square is equal to, by the transformation, minus 1 becomes plus 1, and then x equal to root 1 means x equal to plus or minus 1. What it means? Therefore, zeros of x square minus 1 are minus 1 and plus 1. Okay. Now, basing this one, we can take these x values. Always first one is x. Here, middle term missing, that's why I removed one row here. Second term, second line, x square. Here middle term is not there. Last term we should write this one, minus 1. And here this one is y. This time only sum of these two lines, means these two rows only. Here last one is order pair, x comma y. Now here minus 1 and plus 1 is our answer. So take this side two values and this side two values, means from minus 3. Minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. 0, 1, 2, 3, enough, 3 values here. Now minus 3 whole square is equal to 9. This constant term minus 1 always. Okay, now here minus 2 whole square, next one, 4, minus 1 whole square, 1. This one is 0 square, 0, 1 square, 1, 2 square, 4, 3 square, 9. Now, you can add these two only. Here, 9 minus 1, 8, 4 minus 1, 3, 1 minus 1, 0, 0 minus 1, minus 1, 1 minus 1, 0, 4 minus 1, 3, 9 minus 1, 8. Write the order page. Minus 3, 8. Next one, minus 2, 3. Minus 1, 0. 0, minus 1. 1, 0. 2, 3. 3, 8. Now next point, plot the points. Plot the points on graph sheet. And join them with a smooth curve. Now take a graph sheet. This one is the graph sheet. Here also I taken 2, 2. If you want to take 1, 1, it's your choice. You can take 1 also. I taken 2 here. Okay. On y axis 2 units, on x axis 1 unit. Let us plot the points. Minus 3, 8. Here minus 3, 8. This one is the point. Now, next one, minus 2, 3. Minus 2, 3. 3 means 2 and here, this one. Next, minus 1, 0. Minus 1, 0. On x-axis, 0, minus 1. 0, minus 1 means here half, minus 1. 1, 0, this one, 2, 3, 2, 3 means here, 3, 8, here 3, here 8. Now join with a smooth curve. From here, I will join from here. Now this one is x square minus 1 polynomial. You observe that this curve meets this x-axis in two places. This one is minus 1, 0, and here 1 comma 0. 1 comma 0. Now last working here, we observe that curve meets the x-axis at 2 points. What are those 2 points? Minus 1, 0 and 1 comma 0. Therefore, zeros of polynomial x square minus 1 are minus 1 and 1. Already verification done before only. Okay, is it understood? My request is that pause the video and prepare the notebook. Why? Because these questions are most important. Okay, compulsory one question comes from this Roman. Okay, thank you very much.